Welcome to this SFTP Gateway tutorial by Thorn Technologies. My name is Chris, and today I'll be showing you how to launch SFTP Gateway in Azure. We can start by opening the Azure portal in your web browser. Then you can search for SFTP Gateway in the Azure Marketplace and click Create. This will bring you to the virtual machine creation page. Create or select a resource group where you would like your SFTP Gateway server. Then give the server a name, then select the VM size. For testing purposes, we recommend a B-series VM, and for production servers, we recommend a D-series VM. You can generate a new key pair and it will download the private key, but since I already have a private key, I'm going to select Use Existing Key, then paste my public key into the text area. From here, you can go to the Networking tab to set up the network security group. For the NIC Network Security Group, select Advanced, and under the drop-down box, click the Create New link. This will bring you to the rule set for the Network Security Group. Click the Add Inbound Rule, and this will open the rule form. Then change the source type to IP addresses, and in the source IP field, you want to add your computer's public IP address followed by /32. To get your public IP, you can also go to checkip.dyndns.org. The link being in the description. Then we are going to come down to the destination port range and change this to port 80,443,2222 and change the protocol to TCP. We leave the priority alone, but we want to give this a descriptive name. I am going to name mine My Office. Now we can click Add, and this will attach the inbound rule to the network security group. Here is a diagram that shows the setup for the ports for SFTP Gateway. All traffic on port 22 is forced into the SFTP protocol, and this is left open to the world because SFTP Gateway has an IP allow list feature that can be set on a per user basis in the admin web interface. Port 2222 is used to gain SSH access to the server for logs and maintenance, and ports 80 and 443 are used for traffic to the admin web interface. Ports 2222, 80, and 443 should be locked down to only allow traffic from your system admins through the network security group. From here, you can click OK once you're satisfied with the inbound rules on the network security group. Next, we can click Review and Create. Azure will validate the resources to be created, and once the validation check passes, we can review the information and click Create. Azure will then deploy the necessary resources. This will take a few minutes, so I'll bring you back once this is complete. Once this page reads Deployment Complete, we can click Go to Resource. This will bring us to the VM Details page. From here, you can click the copy button on the public IP address for the server and paste that into any browser to reach the admin web interface. The first time you visit the admin web interface, you will get this privacy warning because SFTP Gateway uses a self-signed SSL certificate. You can just bypass this warning and you will be brought to the SFTP Gateway welcome page where you can create your first admin user. That is all for this video. In the next video, I will show you how to connect SFTP Gateway to an Azure Blob storage account. So don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell to stay up to date on all of our SFTP Gateway tutorials.